Stop the clock.
I truly feel like one of the luckiest human beings to ever walk the planet. Jonathan Larson now is just in my system. He is haunting me in the best possible way. He's a talisman now for me in terms of how to live life as an artist. He's pure love. I think that's part of the legacy that he leaves behind. How do you build your life around things that you love, people that you love, places that you love?
The most important piece of putting this movie together after Lin and after we had Stephen Levinson's script was who is going to play Jonathan Larson.
I went and saw a production of Angels in America starring Andrew Garfield. He was such a life force. I just sort of thought, Jonathan Larson? Maybe? And then I couldn't get the idea out of my head. I just kind of couldn't shake it.
I have been rehearsing all day. I have been up since 4 this morning. I have been trying to write a song for a week and I am nowhere.
I was excited and intrigued at the prospect of him in this role. There's an intelligence to Andrew's process and his work. The only question was, can he sing?
Oh, actually, you know what? Maybe we just skip the songs and then we can get the audience in and out in half an hour.
I said, can you sing? And he said, when are you making the movie? And I said, not for at least a year. And he said, okay, then I can sing.
Yes, I did learn to sing for this role. That was one of the great gifts of Lin taking the risk and asking me if I was interested in going on this adventure with him. And my relationship with musical theater just accelerated because of Lin. I get to be a student again with the greatest teachers.
He had never really sung in a professionally in any way, which was also kind of amazing because he had no bad habits. He was like this new instrument. And by the time we were on set, he just was Jonathan Larson, and he could sing and he could play. And it was extraordinary.
I have rejection letters from every major and minor producer, theater company, record label, and film studio in existence. And in just over a week, I will be 30 years old.
He brings a unique discipline through his work in the theater. And looking at Jonathan Larson's story and what was required from him in this role to learn how to sing, play piano, dance, and also tell the incredibly complicated and nuanced portrait of an artist who is struggling. And so I don't think that there is any other actor that could have brought the amount of depth, the amount of understanding to the role of Jonathan.
Getting to watch Andrew in this role, I felt like I was sharing time with my brother. And I don't think there's a better compliment than that.
What does it take to wake up a generation? How can you make someone take off and fly? We don't wake up and shake up the nation. We'll eat the dust.
What I hope the audience take away from this film is to keep Jonathan Larson alive, and to keep his music, his work alive, and the values that he was espousing alive. Community, art, love, an awareness that we're only here for a short time, so we better make the most of it.
You will never get more commitment than you will from Andrew Garfield. He's one of the greats. And for him to throw himself so completely to Jonathan Larson was one of the great joys of my life.